Welcome to another episode of Mechanics and Duty. Today we have a 2005 Honda Accord 6-cylinder. The car has a problem with the axle. Every time that he turns to the left side, we're hearing clack, 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 clack. So when you're hearing that song in your car, when you're turning and driving the car, that could be that you have a bad axle. I have to make sure and double check it. Okay, first come to first, I'm gonna remove the caliper. I'm gonna remove the upper control arm. I'm gonna be removing the outer timer. And I want to remove the bracket from the chuck if I can get the axe out of it. All right. First thing, 14 in the caliper. These two for the line. For the brake line, the two number 10s. It's two, one, two. What you're gonna do there next is remove the cable for the ABS. You're gonna remove this number 10 with the hole in the bracket. Because the local drum is gonna, the spin is gonna go too far, so you don't wanna make a stretch on that cable. Okay, the cable is loose now for the ABS. Now we're gonna remove the caliper from the bracket. I'm gonna be using a hanger to hold it with the low control arm so I don't make no tension in the cable. No tension in the brake line, so it don't break. Now we're gonna start removing the pins, the quarter pins. This is what I like to use. I like to make it more straight than I can, by hand first, or using my quarter. And after that, I like to take it with the quarter. And just pull it. We're gonna do the same with the outer tire. Okay. After you got this thing done, we want to remove the 14 here by the chuck. But first, we want to remove the outer tire out of the way, or you can have the space that we need. I'm gonna be using some loop as here too. And the axle a little bit. You're gonna be using a 17mm. So we're gonna start that out of the way. So remove the tire rod. You just don't wanna come out of there. You will have to tap it. You don't want to tap it here, and you don't want to hit it here with the hammer. You want to hit it right there. like that's when I get loose. Okay, while we remove the tire first, so we can get access to the 14 here in the back of the chuck for the bracket. We're gonna be using a 14 millimeter. I'm gonna put a little loop on it right in the center,
and right in the back a little bit.
That's a 14 millimeter. After you release that, you're gonna release the bottom of the bracket. For the bottom of the bracket, you're gonna be using a 17. I'm gonna be using a 17 with a wrench because sometimes it's pink, so it don't go together. I'm gonna use a little bit loop too, okay? After you got air out, this is what I'm doing. I'm turning with the wrench, so you get loose, I'm pulling with my fingers. Together. Sometimes these bolts don't want to come out. What you used to do, if you don't want to come out, you take a punch with a hammer and you hit it right in the middle. That's why I got the little flat thing, so you don't miss the middle, so you can hit it right in the middle before you come out. Okay? After that, we're gonna release the actual bolt. I'm gonna be using a 36 millimeter. Like you guys can see, it's really hard to pull it that back, to release a little bit. So I'm gonna be using the punch right in the center. That's why I got a little hole for you, don't the punch, don't jump out of it when you're hitting it. And we just wanna tap it back. When you got it like that, it's moving back and forward when you hit it, that's when it's loose. Now we're gonna hit the 17 and the upper control arm. Okay, you wanna release it up to there always, in the first. The first time. Now we're gonna hit it with the hammer. You don't wanna hit it there. You don't wanna hit it there, definitely not. And you wanna hit it here. Wanna bring the ball down and leave it there? For whatever reason, I miss when I'm hitting it. I don't wanna damage the thread. So, you wanna hit it right here, this part. So I'm gonna hit it right there. One, two. As you guys can see, it released down already. Now we're gonna finish to release the number 17. You release the 17, you're gonna have the spindle loose. At this point, you wanna release the bracket down. How you do that? You take the hammer and you just tap it down like this. Now, you're gonna try to get the bracket out of the way like this. Make sure you put it to the side. Make sure the same way that you take it off, the same way it's gonna go in. Make sure. Don't put it like this, you have to put it like that. Okay. Now, I'm gonna tap a little bit more. Like this. And like this, you just wanna work out your way. Bring the axle out. Sometimes it could be a little tricky, but you will find a way. Like this. Right? I want to show you guys the condition of the axles. These Honda's axles, they have a problem. They start getting rusty. As you guys can see. The rust go all the way inside that rubber piece that's in the middle. What happened there, when the axle, you got original axles and they're really rusty, it could be getting a snap from here, where the rubber here is. That's like 80% of the times when the axle snap from Honda is from here where it snap, where that rubber ring it is. Now, guys, I wanna show you guys how to remove the axle from the transmission. All right, this is the axle that we wanna remove. First thing that you wanna do, you wanna put something to drain. Because if you have a bad transmission seal by the axle, it's gonna leak out the transmission oil, or if you got too much oil in the transmission, so it will leak out from there. All right, first thing that you wanna do, you wanna get something to drain the oil, because if you have a bad transmission seal, or you have a, if it's overflow, if they got too much transmission fluid, it's gonna leak out from there, from the axle when I remove it. So make sure you put the drain pan in the bottom. Now, you wanna take like a pry bar, and you're gonna go right here, like between the axle and the transmission, and you just wanna give it a really push. What you're gonna do, you're gonna put the pry bar in the back, and yank it really hard, it will come off. After you got it like that, you wanna hold it with two hands when you're removing it. The axe out of the car already. All right, guys, now we have the brand new axle. We're ready to put it inside by the transmission. This is a little trick that I'm gonna show you guys. This trick most of the mechanic they don't know. This is something gonna make your life a lot easier. I'm gonna use some special grease that they use to grease the bearings inside the transmission and everything. It's gonna get itself in the oil, in the transmission oil. But what I like to do, I like to put a little bit grease to center the ring. If you don't center that ring when you put it inside, you're gonna have a hard time, buddy, getting that thing inside. This is gonna make your life way more easy when you center that ring. I put a little bit grease so the ring don't move with the movement. As you guys can see, it's there. Now you're gonna get the new axle. Slice it inside. Okay. Go confirm with the light that it's inside the good. This is why you're looking. Okay. Now we're gonna tap it with the hammer. Now we're gonna hit it with the rubber mallet. You don't wanna damage the thread here. I'm gonna show you guys on the camera inside how it goes inside. Alright, I'm gonna start hammering it inside. Okay, well, you want to slide the bracket. You just want to let it see there. Now we're going to try to get the new axle inside the hub. So you got the axle inside the hub there. We want to start putting everything back together. Okay. After you got the axle inside the hub, we want to start putting everything back together. First thing that you're going to do is slide the bracket back up. Now you guys can see the bracket lock in one spot. You have like a little dove in the back. Make sure that you put it in the dove correctly. Now I'm gonna put the port in first. We're gonna tighten it right there. I just want to set up everything so I can torque later on. Just use to guide it. Okay, now I'm going to give me a tool. They're going to help me to bring this thing up. Coming right back. For this part, what I did, I put the transmission jack here, push it up, and bring it down. And put the 17. Now you want to set up the bracket in the low control arm. Like that. Now you tap. Now that we got this, we're going to put the 17 off in the back. Now like this, I can torque, I only have to torque it and put it with the wrench there. We're going to put the other tire back too. After you get in this point, you have to torque everything. I want to torque it and I'm coming right back with you guys. Okay, after you torque the upper arm, the outer tire rod, and you torque the axle bolt, you just want to come here and start setting up everything, blacking out everything in security. For that, I'm going to be using a quarter pin. For the quarter pin, you just slice it inside, and you bend it through the back. Like this, make sure you lock it. Same thing here with the outer tire rod. Make sure that you lock it. Now, this is one of the important things when you're replacing the axle. You have to lock the axle. For lock the axle, we're gonna be using a hammer, and we're gonna be. And we're gonna be using a chisel. What you wanna do, you're gonna bend that ear to go inside that lock there. This is the lock for the action. So, you take your chisel and a hammer. You make sure that you lock it like that. Now we're gonna make sure, give another one. And that's how you lock the axle there. Now that we lock everything and secure the components, now we want to start running the water back. This is the wire for the ABS. This is something that you guys can get in any hardware store, a mechanic store. Compress a little bit the caliper inside. Now we want to release the caliper from the hook. When you're gonna put the caliper, you wanna make sure that the line is gonna be stretched, or it's gonna be with the wire torn. Make sure it's gonna go with how it was before. We're gonna put the two number 10s for the line. It's gonna go with the bracket. After you do all that, you pretty much finish already. We have to torque the number 10 and torque the caliper. And that's it. This is how you replace the axle in a 2005 Honda Accord 6-cylinder. Bada bing, bada boom.